Well, hello everyone, Dan Hurd with Dan Hurd Prospecting here. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, welcome. I hope to earn your subscription today. I am here on a little creek that runs into the Fraser River. A friend of mine saw that I was looking for a facetable sized garnet, gemstone garnet, something big enough I could make an actual faceted gem out of. And he said, Dan, try this creek. I've found big ones there before. So I found my way into the creek here. I did one little quick pan and sure enough, I saw garnets in it. So I've got the gem sieve out and I'm gonna see if I can find myself a big gemmy garnet. That's the plan. Wish me luck and I hope you enjoy. Now, since I last did a gem sieve video, I've been working with Arbor Fabricating in coming up with a commercially available gem sieve. The one I have been using up to now is something I built in my own shop, but this is one that people can actually go out and purchase at Arbor Fabricating. I will leave a link in the description below. This is the first time I'm using it. I've only actually flipped twice now, and so far so good. It's made from stainless steel, nice sturdy mesh, sturdy ring. It seems to be able to take the abuse of the flips because they do get hit pretty hard when you flip them. And I'm very happy with it. If you'd like your own gem sieve, I'll leave a link below. Now, unfortunately, it's starting to rain. Gem sieving works best on a sunny day because the bright sunlight really shows off the gems really well. Unfortunately, it's a dreary, rainy day today. Gotta go find some gravels that could host some bigger garnets now. I'll look around. Now, garnets are like gold. They're heavy, so they tend to congregate. They collect in places where heavy things collect, like behind a big rock, on bedrock, inside corners, that kind of stuff. So I'm gonna try to dig behind that big rock and see if maybe there's some bigger garnets right there. I will be using a quarter inch classifier today. Therefore, the biggest garnet I could get would be up to a quarter inch. I forgot to bring my Arbor Fabricating classifier with me on my trip, so I ended up using one of these cheap plastic ones. I do recommend the Arbor Fabricating classifiers. They're amazing. Again, link below. There we go. A nice, full gem sieve. Now, for those of you who haven't seen one of my other gem sieving videos, I'll explain this to you. A gem sieve is like a gold pan, except it's for collecting gems, not gold. And it will collect gold as well if you have a big enough piece. The idea behind them is that gems are heavier than the rest of the gravel around them, and they're gonna sink to the bottom if you work it just right. The way you work it is you pulse it in the water. Pulsing it brings everything heavy to the bottom, and then you rock it. Rocking it side to side brings everything into a line along the middle. Once it's in the middle, you pulse it, and all the heavies that were in that line sink to the bottom in a line. Do that two or three times, and now everything that's all the garnets will be in a line right across the center. If I rotate it 90 degrees, they're in a line this way, do it again, it brings that line into the center. And it should make a perfect little round dot in the center of the gravels. Later on, we're gonna flip this upside down, and whatever's on the bottom will end up being on the top, and we'll get to see what all the heavies look like. In this case, we're looking for garnet. There we go. When you feel confident you've done enough, you lift it out of the water, tip it on its side to drain out any excess water, and it really solidifies everything so when we go and flip it in a second, it stays together. When you go to flip it, you're gonna find a nice flat area. This is where I've done a few flips already. You're gonna flip it towards you, not away, towards you, one, two, three. Lift it up. And there you go. All of your heaviest things, in this case the garnets, are all right in the center in a perfect little dot. You see the heaviest things, the garnets in the center. You see some black material around it that's magnetite and hematite and stuff that are still slightly heavy. And then all the rest of the gravel's going out. And at this point, you just sort of bring them all together into one spot that you can grab easily and put them aside for later refining. I'm full of garnet. Woohoo! Here comes the sun! I like that. The rain has stopped. The sun is coming out. I like it.
Hey,
looking good. And I do see one really nice one right there.
There's a nice gem right there. Ah, that's a good size one. I'm liking it. Look at how red and gemmy these ones are.
Love these old train structures. The train tracks are just up above me here. Here's an old rock wall.
And a big, creepy tunnel.
The river just goes through underneath the train tracks through this old stone, actual real stonework tunnel. Isn't that spectacular? Love the history down here along the Fraser. So now, careful panning can reduce these concentrates down to just basically the pure garnets, or you can just go through there and pick out the ones that you want. But, you know, after maybe a dozen sieve-fulls, I don't have that much concentrate, and I don't see any really large garnets. So even though this river was supposed to have big ones, maybe my definition of big and my friend's definition of big were slightly different. I think I'm gonna call her quits at this spot and go and see if I can find somewhere else that might show me bigger garnets.
So the next creek was 10 times better, if not more, but that will be for another video.
Now for Christmas, I'm gonna be putting together a very special pay dirt bag. It's gonna have red, green, and gold, the Christmas colors. Gold, white, Anyhow, Christmas special pay dirt. It's gonna have red garnets, green peridot, and yes, placer gold. All in one bag for $25 in my store on my website, www.danhurdprospecting.com. And if you want it by Christmas, order early. Shipping is taking forever these days. Hope you all enjoyed my little adventure in gem sieving and searching for fascinable garnets, which I didn't find. I could not make these videos if it weren't for my patrons on Patreon. If you are a patron, thank you so much. If you'd like to learn more about how you can support Dan Hurd Prospecting, making weekly videos in prospecting and gem hunting and rock hounding, treasure hunting in general, head off to patreon.com/danhurd, where you can learn more. Hope you're all having an amazing day out there. And until the next one, bye.